Enter the user data in the job specification. Then transfer the values specified in the alignment recommendation to the bench alignment. If you are not using an alignment tool such as Pros-A or L.A.S.A.R. assembly, please observe the alignment recommendation for plumb line alignment. If you are using an alignment tool, the required specifications such as prosthetic side, heel height and foot rotation should be carried out using the alignment tool. Follow the alignment recommendation for the knee joint and the foot in case soft. Clamp the knee joint in the alignment tool using the adapter inserts specified by Ottobock and adjust the length according to the user's data. Then connect the socket to the knee joint. Pay particular attention to the socket flexion angle and socket position specified in the alignment recommendation and adjust the components accordingly. Check the distance between the socket and the hydraulics with the knee joint in maximum flexion. Also make sure there is space between the socket and the top of the knee when the knee joint is in full extension. Tighten all screws to the specified torque. Finally, calibrate the Kenevo. Start the static alignment optimization by checking the length of the prosthesis. This can be done by using a pelvic level which is placed on the iliac crests with even pressure. Additionally, you can use the L.A.S.A.R. posture or 3D L.A.S.A.R. posture. When using the L.A.S.A.R. posture, the weight line should run through C7, the 7th cervical vertebrae and the gluteal fold in an ideal case. When viewed in the coronal plane, the vertical load line should be located up to 2 cm lateral to the middle of the prosthetic knee joint. At least 40% of the user's body weight should be placed on the prosthetic side. Now view the user in the sagittal plane with a prosthetic leg on the L.A.S.A.R. posture. If you have followed the alignment recommendation for the sagittal plane and taken into account the required socket flexion angle and position, small changes to the plantar flexion of the foot should result in a good sagittal alignment. This means that the vertical load line depicted by the laser should lie approximately 30 mm anterior to the rotational center of the knee. Don't forget that the ankle screws will need to be torqued again to 15 Newton meters after you have loosened them. The user should now stand with both legs on the L.A.S.A.R. posture. The weight line is determined in this position. The distance between the weight line and the vertical load line gives you good insight into any horizontal forces affecting the user and how he or she is working to compensate for these forces. The difference between the two measurement situations should not exceed 15 mm here. Take into account that recalibration should be carried out after every change to the prosthetic alignment. You can also check the socket flexion angle by using the simple test shown in the video. If the toes are nearly at the same position, dynamic alignment optimization can be carried out. Dynamic alignment optimization involves fine-tuning the prosthetic alignment in the frontal and sagittal planes while the user is walking.